We are facing an obesity epidemic today. The USA is one of the leaders, with over one-third of US adults being obese, and every 8th US child. Scientists predict that the trend will increase even more in the future. This is very alarming, because being overweight, and especially being obese, dramatically increases one's risk of premature death. But how can we battle this threat? Which strategy should we use, and is there a way out? Let's face it, we live in a comfortable world. Our daily life has become utterly convenient. We basically wake up in the morning, in a heated up room, under blankets, in a comfortable bed. And our breakfast, after taking out the ingredients from the fridge and the stove, is made within minutes. Time for work. Let's get out of the flat, into the elevator, into the car, driving until we are sitting in a comfortable chair in our comfortable heated up office again. This is not what we are. This environmental shift is like teaching a dog how to be a cat. May sound stupid, but consider this. The information age started 2 generations ago. The Industrial Revolution was 7 generations ago. The Agricultural Revolution 350 generations ago. But we lived as hunter and gatherers for over 84,000 generations. Over 90% of human history is full of daily physical activity to survive in a harsh and painful world. Which means our genome is perfectly suited for our past environment, not for our present one. And there's no sign of our civilization getting back to that. Looking at the evidence, our life will even be more convenient in the future. Mainly because we value time, therefore we need faster transportation. And of course because we are lazy fucks. The first strategy to deal with the obesity epidemic, therefore, is to make our life a little bit less comfortable. Meaning adding more physical activity, even if it's random and unstructured. Walk to the supermarket instead of taking your car. Use a standing desk instead of sitting the whole day. Throw away your hoverboard. I mean seriously, who buys these? A little bit of daily physical activity will add up and help you stay lean and mean in the long run. Especially searching for food used to be a pretty huge part in our hunter and gatherer days. And one thing that pretty much comes along with a convenient life is our food choices. I'm talking especially about meat and dairy products. Contrary to the popular belief, we did not eat that much meat in our hunter and gatherer days. If you decide to research ancient crab, which apparently some scientists did, you realize that we ate over 100 grams of fiber in a single day, which results to, for example, 10 kgs of lettuce. And even if you go back before our hunter and gatherer days, we basically ate what the great apes are eating, meaning over 95% plants for over 20 million years. That may explain why meat and dairy products are closely linked to obesity. In a study considering over 60,000 persons, vegans were the only one having a normal BMI. And I can tell you why. A plant-based diet makes staying on a low body fat percentage much easier, because you basically can't eat all the bad stuff, and the stuff you do eat is pretty low on calories. Following a smart vegan diet, therefore, is a safe structure to stay lean in our comfortable world. Just don't go too hard with soft drinks and vegetable oils. So maybe combine this with strategy number 3. Getting the right education. Staying on a healthy body fat doing a normal diet is hard. Mainly because of the food industry playing against us. Have you ever realized that this is not a good snack for a child? Or this? Or this? or this or this or this, although completely not suitable for a child, they're especially marketed for those. Why? Because children are not that educated. Children don't know yet what is healthy. So it's on you, their parents, to show them real nutrition. By the way, have you even realized that they're claiming to have less cocoa and more milk? As this would even be a good thing to have. But this ridiculous marketing does not only focus on children. Ever realize that this is not a fitness breakfast? That this cookie, although really tasty, consists of 2 servings? I mean, who only eats half and let the other part decay? Most people don't know that. Most people don't know what is healthy. Get back to the basics. Natural, plant-based is healthy. Not processed food marketed with less sodium or more protein. It's like instead of selling you diarrhea, selling you more solid crap. So it's important to learn stuff like this in school. Learn about nutrition and health and fitness and why you should make it a priority. We will live in a more developed world in the future. Therefore, an even more convenient way of living and more temptation. Studies have proven that increased wealth of nation brings more obesity with it, but only in people with low levels of education. We are facing an obesity epidemic today, so it's time to get uncomfortable, plant-based and smart together. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you for your time, thank you for your trust. Don't forget to leave a like, maybe do subscribe. Leave me a comment on what type of video you want to see next. Have a great day.